हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश सेशन. गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी. सो टुडे आई हैव टेकन अ फर्स्ट पोयम. इट्स कॉल्ड मार्च, रिटन बाय विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ. अबाउट पोएट विलियम वर्ड्सवर्थ वॉज बॉर्न ऑन अप्रैल 7, 1770. ही बिलोंग्स टू द फैमिली ऑफ लैंड ओनर्स. He was popular as nature poet because his poetry deals with nature. So he was very much popular because the way he write a poem regarding the nature. So we used to call, or he was popular as nature poet. So dear children, let's look into the poem. Take out your pencils, keep in your hand, and wherever you find difficulties or whichever new words for you, please underline it. So in this poem there are archaic words. So archaic word means something very old or old fashioned. You know the old fashioned, right? This kind of costumes or this kind of dresses were used by our grandmas or great grandma. So archaic words, they are the words which they used in a old literary. So there are three words, archaic words. There are three archaic words. The first one is doth. Doth means do or does. Second one is hath. Hath means has or have. Anon means very shortly or quickly. So these are the archaic words which we are not using right now, but these words were used in a old literary books. So let's jump into our glossary. There are 11 difficult words or new words they have given. You can see on the screen also, and you can also look into your books if you have a textbooks. Even textbooks also the same words have given. The first one is twitter, that means to make a number of short rapid sound. Dot, which already said, it's an archaic word. Glitter, shine brightly with flashing points of light. Retreat, go back. Fair ill, be unsuccessful. Fluff boy, a boy who leads a horse that is pulling the fluff. Whoop, make a loud cry as a joy. Fountain, a natural spring of water. Prevail, gain control. Or victory, win a fight. Seen, something spread out to view. Anon, in a short time or soon. So this poem is written in March, brings out the essence of nature and shows how the human life is affected with the withdrawal of winter and commencement of spring season. So here, in this poem, we will learn, there are different kinds of season we have, right? We have spring season, we have summer season, we have autumn season, and we have winter season. So before March, we have a winter season, right? Until the month of Jan or Feb, we have a winter season where it is very cold. So this poem was written in the March, and March, in the March poem, it shows the importance of nature, and it shows that how human beings are affected when this winter season has gone and we welcome the spring season. In the title of poem, March shows that it's a time of gradual, that is slow change, where spring takes over and the last of snow melts away. So in this poem it shows a time where we are changing. So before March month, we can see everywhere the snow, and once the March arrives, right? So what we can see the spring is taking over the snow. The sun is falling on the snow and the snow starts melting, and that's how we welcome spring season. And about this spring season, we can see in the poem March. So let me recite the poem, the first 10 lines, and you can also recite it after me and underline the words which you feel are difficult. The cock is crowing, the stream is flowing, the small birds twitter, the lake doth glitter. The green field sleeps in the sun. The oldest and the youngest are at work with the strongest. The cattle are grazing, their heads never raising. There are 40 feeding like one. So in this stanza, the first stanza, the cock is crowing. The meaning of the cock is crowing. When the cock will crow? Yes, the cock will crow in the early morning, right? You have seen if nearby your house, if the cock is there, what the cock will do? It make a sound, right? It make a sound and it's wake up you, right? It's wake up you. So this time call, this is a indicate that we have come, that there is a new day or the rise of the day, okay? And the stream is flowing. So as usual, the stream is flowing, the birds are twittering, the birds are, twitter means chirping, you know, you can hear the sound of a birds, like chirping. What is chirping? It makes a sound, right? It makes a sound. And the lake doth glitter. So when the cock is crowing, right, the stream is also flowing. The stream is keep on flowing, you can see in the picture. And then the sun is arise, right? The sun is arising. When sun is arising, the sun's rays are falling on the lake, which makes the lake to glitter. Glitter means to shine. It's shining. The lake is shining. The green field sleeps in the sun. And now what happening? The green field is welcoming the sun. And then what we see? The oldest and the youngest are at work with the strongest. So now when the sun rays have done, when the new day has come, what you will see in the field? You will see in the field that oldest people or the youngest people, all are what they're doing? They all are working in the field. Okay, they all are working in the field. The cattle are grazing. What the cattle are doing? What is cattle? So cattle is nothing but the cow, buffalo, sheep, right? So these are grazing. So the meaning of grazing means eating. When the cattle are eating, it is called as grazing. Okay, and their heads never raising. Even the oldest, the people who are working in the field and the cattle who are eating, they are not lifting up their heads. That means they're concentrating on their work. So this stanza shows that this is a routine life of the countryside. So when the cock is crow, and this is the work of a countryside. So when I'm reading this stanza, when I'm reading this word, I can imagine the nature. Wow, what a beautiful nature it will be, right? The sun, the birds, the cock, the lake, and everywhere you can see the greenery. So I can imagine the beauty of nature. So the first two stanzas says about the emotions which is connected to the nature, or you can see the imagining the beauty of the nature. Stanza: like an army defeated, the snow hath retreated, and now doth fare ill on the top of the bare hill. The bluff boy is wooing anon anon, there's joy in the mountains, there's life in the fountains. Small clouds are sailing, blue sky prevailing, the rain is over and gone. So now in the third stanza we see, right, what is an army? Yeah, so army means a soldier, right? So here what happened? When the spring season has come, the spring has defeated the snow, and the snow has retreated. Retreated means moves back. So snow accept the failure from the sun, and it moves back. And now doth fare ill on the top of the bare hill. So here what happened? Now everything is free, right? Snow has been unsuccessful, snow has gone back, and what he can see on the top of the bare hill? The bare hill means everything is empty, there is no vegetation. Okay, why there is no vegetation? Because the snow has covered the mountain. And when the snow started melting out, we can see only a empty hill. And there was a plough boy. Plough boy means a boy who leads a horse, right? A boy who leads a horse. So he was enjoying, he was crying out, he was crying out. Why he was crying out in joy? Because he can see the mountains, he can see there is a joy in the mountain, he can see there is life in the fountain. What is a fountain? Fountain also, when there is a cold season or winter season, what will happen? The water will turn into the ice, right? So when there is a sun rays falls on the ice, the ice turns into the water. So we can see, the poet is saying that we can see there's a life in the mountain. Okay, and what we can see, we can also see there are clouds, small clouds which are sailing in the sky. That means when during the winter season, you cannot see the clouds, okay? But now what you can see a blue sky, and you can see a small, small clouds are sailing. Are sailing means are moving, and the rain is over and gone. The rain is nothing but the moisturization, the snow, right? The snow has melted and has gone back. So this is a poem written by William Wordsworth, where he tells about the season, that how people, how human beings welcome the season, the March season, into their life, and how much they feel happy. So in this poem, we have few rhyming words which can be put in the next slide. So now in this class, I'm going to introduce you rhyming words. So what is a rhyming words? Rhyming words are two or more words that have the same or similar ending sound. If they sound the same or similar, they are called as rhyme. So if you have to check the sound of the words, if they are similar, if you end with the same sound, that means a rhyme word. If it ends with the same word, it is also called as a rhyming word. So from the poem, I have given you one example, crowing, flowing. Okay, I can give you one more example, game, rain. Okay, glitter, twitter, youngest, strongest, raising. So there are almost 10 to 15 words are there in the poem. So you have to write, you have to select all the rhyming words from the poem, and you have to write in your classwork. So I'll be giving you the format of writing English notes in classwork. Please follow that. Read the poem and understand it, and have a good day. Bye.